شيكل مش دولار.
ستار ستريت, the traditional entrance to Bethlehem, is uncommonly busy on Christmas Eve. Balloon vendors and children dressed as Santa Claus, even politicians, walk the path leading to the Church of Nativity, where most Christians say Jesus Christ was born. For many in Bethlehem, Christmas is a time to resist through celebrations, to show that comfort and togetherness are not only possible in dark times, but a way to see them through.
Also, it's a resistance, it's a kind of resistance. Like we said, it's, you know, because we have the bad situations, and it's really resistance. Because when you gather a lot of people here together, and it's forbidden for, not most of them, but some of them, they are forbidden to come here. And if you are here, it's a kind of resistance.
Since early Friday morning, scout groups from all over the West Bank arrived in the city of Bethlehem, laying their drums and bagpipes, spreading the atmosphere of Christmas. Many in Bethlehem, a city one-third Christians, have the day off and have decided to spend it with their families. They say they are glad to see that Bethlehem has become so popular than usual. Business is good, or at least better than most days today. Balloon lions, flowers, and Dora the Explorer float around, sold by this young man. 2010 Nobel Peace Prize nominee and Member of Parliament Mustafa Barghouthi, like many Palestinian political figures, joined the local families today during the celebrations.
And the other thing which I see here very beautiful is in Bethlehem is this unity between Muslims and Christians, Palestinian Muslims and Christians who are unified. It looks like not just a Christmas, but like a national celebration day for all Palestinians.
Fuad Tawil, the Latin Patriarch of the Holy Land, arrived in the city and was greeted by local leaders, including the mayor of Bethlehem, Dr. Victor Batarsa. The celebrations will continue all through the evening and will end with the arrival of Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas to start the midnight mass. For Palestine News Network, this is Ghassan Bannoura.